Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. 21st century astrophysicists hold to an astounding belief that purely gravitational phenomena are the cause of unfathomably powerful electromagnetic energies and emissions in deep space. Consensus scientific theory maintains that mechanical and kinetic processes, collisions, explosions, gravitational collapse, and heating produce mysterious magnetism, which causes the measured electrical effects. From the extraordinarily densely packed neutrons, which are thought to compose magnetized spinning neutron stars, which produce pulsing radio and X-ray emissions, or supermassive stars going supernova, collapsing into black holes and producing extraordinary gamma-ray bursts, or the nearly infinite compression of matter that is thought to constitute a black hole. These theoretical phenomena have been exhaustively codified through mathematical modeling and supercomputer simulations, and imposing sums of taxpayer money have been spent on the most sophisticated technologies, resulting in tweaks to the models rather than testing alternatives. What experimentalists observe in nature and the laboratory is of secondary importance in gravity-centric cosmology, whose symbol of genius remains the mathematician. No clearer example of this can be seen than in the standard astrophysical interpretation of the largest scale lightning observed in the universe. As we will see, lightning is indeed the only valid interpretation of the spectacular phenomena. In our recent installment of our series, The Top 10 Reasons the Universe is Electric, we discussed the quote, mysterious nature of cosmic jets. From the light years long filamentary jets of so-called Herbig-Haro objects, to extragalactic radio jets that stretch for hundreds of thousands of light years, and even beyond. What mechanism is capable of producing these high energy jets across such spectacular distances? And what confines the jets and prevents the material from dispersing in the quote, vacuum of space? Astrophysicists have never successfully explained the phenomena, and a new scientific report only underscores the desperate need for new theoretical pathways. On October 16, 2017, the website phys.org reported on the cosmic jet of a quasar that stretches for an incredible 300,000 light years. The report begins by misrepresenting a popular theory as an unassailable fact. It states, quasars are galaxies with massive black holes at their cores. From this one belief, it seems inevitable that only confusion can follow. The report describes scientists' ongoing struggle to explain the X-ray emissions of the collimated bipolar jets from quasars as follows. Even after more than two decades of study, however, there is still no clear conclusion as to the physical mechanism actually responsible for the X-ray emission. On the jet's electrical nature, a vital clue is found in the report's following statement. Both the magnetic field strength and the particle velocities are, remarkably, quite constant all along the length of this jet. Of course, both the constancy of the jet's particle velocities and magnetic field strength are the undeniable hallmarks of lightning. However, since astronomers hold to the unbending belief that electricity causes nothing in space, including unfathomably powerful electrical discharges, the confusion only deepens with ever finer technological data. A perfect example can be seen in a 2015 NASA Hubble report, which describes a so-called shock collision of mysterious knots inside a, quote, black hole jet. A Hubble time-lapse video shows the knots in the jet, which form like, quote, pearls on a string. The report begins, when you're blasting through space more than 98% of the speed of light, you may need driver's insurance. Astronomers have discovered for the first time a rear-end collision between two high-speed knots of ejected matter. The report continues, such extragalactic jets are not well understood. They appear to transport energetic plasma in a confined beam from the active nucleus of the host galaxy. The new analysis suggests that shocks produced by collisions within the jet further accelerate particles and brighten the regions of colliding material. Of course, the collimated and knotty form of the jets are the well-documented signatures of electrical discharges in plasma. As we will see as we continue, it is not a coincidence that both stars and galaxies form like pearls on a string, and the plasma filaments connecting galaxies are now a subject of growing scientific investigation. In the electric universe, it is not a supermassive black hole at the center of a galaxy, but a donut-shaped object called a plasmoid, which, unlike a black hole, has a proven physical reality. In plasma laboratories on Earth, a plasmoid is an ultra-high-density energy storage phenomenon. Electric currents flow equatorially inward to the plasmoid, where energy is stored electromagnetically. The electric universe model proposes simply that so much concentrated energy is stored in the galactic plasmoid that it may be the compact source, whose mass is attributed to a hypothetical black hole. As the plasmoid's charge density increases along the axis of the quote donut, it creates the well-known plasma feature called a double layer, which can explode or release energy axially in the form of cosmic jets and other spectacular emissions. The scalability of plasma phenomena is, of course, paramount in cosmic investigations. The Nobel Prize winner and father of plasma cosmology, Hannes Alfvén, proposed that plasma phenomena can be scaled to an incredible 28 orders of magnitude. In fact, in 1986, Alfvén spoke at a NASA-sponsored conference on the astrophysical role of double layers. He stated, "Double layers in space should be classified as a new type of celestial object. One example is the double radio sources. It is tentatively suggested that X-ray and gamma-ray bursts may be due to exploding double layers." In the aforementioned NASA report, the authors propose that heating and mysterious magnetism are responsible for the jets' velocities and collimation. They state, "One theory is that material falling onto the central object is superheated and ejected along the object's spin axis. Powerful magnetic fields constrain the material into a narrow jet." But of course, superheating alone does not explain the origins and extraordinary velocities of the jets. And why the magnetic field should exist at all to confine the jets remains completely unexplained in standard theory. As we've outlined in many recent episodes, cosmic-scale magnetic fields were, until very recently, considered to be, quote, not important in standard astrophysics. So it's not surprising that countless scientific reports in the last decade feature expressions of surprise and perplexity from astronomers who are detecting magnetism everywhere throughout the cosmos. The perplexity must continue until astronomers integrate a simple law of physics: electric currents produce magnetic fields. Today, we are seeing the inevitable confirmation of the electrical nature of cosmic jets. As we've reported previously, in 2011, a team of scientists measured the electric current in the jet shooting from the galaxy 3C303. They estimated the strength of the current at 10 to the 18th power amps, or the equivalent of a trillion bolts of lightning. Of course, the team still holds to the theory that a supermassive black hole ultimately produces the spectacular electric current. But as we've also recently reported, at an even greater cosmic scale, it has become undeniable that the electrical cosmic jets have nothing to do with black holes. In 2016, a Royal Astronomical Society press release reported the discovery that, quote, "Supermassive black holes in a region of the distant universe are all spinning out radio jets in the same direction," a lead investigator, Professor Ramil Dave, said of the findings. "This is not obviously expected based on our current understanding of cosmology. It's a bizarre finding." The problem for proponents of black hole theory is that at these incredible cosmic distances, no mechanism exists to affect the directionality of the jets. Unfortunately, rather than pausing to question the very existence of the hypothetical black holes, which have never been observed by anyone, the researchers proposed the ad hoc theory that the spin alignment of the galaxies must have somehow occurred in the early universe, causing the black holes to spin in the same direction. But in the electric universe, such cosmic alignments are in fact predicted and required if the dominant organizational force is electromagnetism. Space, across the vastest cosmic distances, has a substructure of twisted pair current filaments, with stars and galaxies forming along them like pearls on a string, and having their spin axes aligned along their filament. Science discovery continues to confirm this prediction. In 2015, scientists using the Herschel Space Observatory reported the detection in unprecedented detail of filamentary structures throughout the Milky Way galaxy. A phys.org report states of the finding. One of the key aspects that emerged from these observations is the presence of a filamentary network nearly everywhere in our galaxy's interstellar medium. The picture that is emerging is that these structures are closely linked to the formation of stars. The principal investigator of the survey stated, "The greatest surprise was the ubiquity of filaments in these nearby clouds and their intimate connection with star formation." The picture of protostars forming due to gravitational collapse in molecular clouds is now falsified by direct observation. Instead, stars, as well as galaxies, form like pearls on a string, which we must find if the electromagnetic Z-pinch effect is responsible for star formation. The telltale signature of the electric currents that confine the star-forming filaments was also detected in the aforementioned study. The principal investigator said of the finding, "These observations reveal that filaments, which may extend to several light years in length, appear to have a universal width of about 1/3 of a light year. This suggests that something fundamental is lurking underneath." As previously stated, the universal width of filaments, which is completely unexpected in standard reasoning, is not coincidental. On Earth, constant width is observed in the most powerful natural electrical discharge phenomenon, lightning. In fact, for many mysterious astrophysical phenomena, it is lightning that works as the most promising natural analog. We then ask the question, if Occam's razor were actually applied in astrophysical circles, would consensus theory remain that gravity is the most likely, that is to say, simplest explanation for the undeniable, stupendous electric currents in space? On our own Earth, the phenomena we experience in nature and the laboratory may surely help demystify the ongoing mysteries in our electric universe.
For continuous updates on space news from the electric universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.